All right. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to the GSL Up and Down Matches. I am Moltrap. I am here with Doa.
That's right. Hi,
we are
I'm
both,
Doa.
That's him.
That's Moltrap.
We are both here.
We are.
To witness history in the making.
Yeah.
We are here to see who goes up to Code S or stays in Code S and who is going to fall down into Code A to possibly be eliminated from the GSL altogether in the next Code A season.
A bit dangerous.
It is a dangerous situation.
Those first rounds, man, if you get knocked out there, you have to go through the Code A qualifiers again, which is pretty brutal. It's like walking on coals while like eagles swoop down and peck at you in the snow.
Yeah. That's,
but the coals are still hot.
That's pretty much exactly what it's like.
Yeah.
And having done that myself, I can attest to the difficulty of that kind of situation.
You've done a lot of crazy
things. I've done a lot.
Tell them about what you told me. Let's do that later, actually. Let's talk about the players first. And here's our first player, MVP Violet. I think a very impressive Zerg player finally falling to MVP. There's no shame in that.
Nope.
Four wins, two losses in Code A.
And look at that. Playing against Yu-Gi-Oh!, another Zerg player, so he's got some good ZVZ wins under his belt.
He also beat Ace, too, which I think is a very good Protoss player.
Yeah.
He didn't perform that well in Code A, but Violet played so well. I mean, he's definitely one of those Zergs that's coming up. He's a former Warcraft 3 pro.
Yeah.
Took down some bigger names in the qualifiers to get into Code A. And here's our next player. It's Zenix Kyrix, a longtime GSL player. He's at 15-15. Ooh, so today's going to decide if he's going to have a winning or losing record in the GSL.
Yeah.
That's exciting. Now, he did lose to Lucira, but then again.
Yeah, but who doesn't?
Yeah.
Except
and
for SC.
He did try, like, crazy nine pool cheeses.
Yeah. That was really disappointing,
and
actually.
And here's our third player, OGS The Wind. Coach for OGS. 12-13 losses. Has been around GSL for a long time as well. Lost recently to San MC and Supernova.
Been around StarCraft for a long time as well, for that matter.
Certainly has.
That was a little bit disappointing, the way Kyrix went out in that game.
Yeah.
Just kind of like did some cheesiness and didn't even try and go for a longer game.
There they are.
And there they are indeed. MVP Violet on the left, the Warcraft 3 pro, formerly an Orc player, and Zenix Kyrix, who actually has a style of ZVT named after him for pioneering and championing the mass Ling Baneling, the high economy Baneling aggression, as Artosis calls it.
He was really one of the first people to really make that work.
Yeah.
High profile man.
And it took Marine King control to counter that style, which is not something that many people can accomplish. Now, we are going to get into game one here in just a moment on Zelnog Caverns. It is going to be a Zerg versus Zerg matchup, and I'm very anxious to see how it goes. Both players, very, very good players. I'd say Violet probably has the edge in this matchup, to be honest, but let's find out here at the GSL Up and Down Matches.
And of course, the pile of diamonds holding up the GSL medallion will be given to Moltrap's my favorite player. We get to decide who becomes super rich. Will it be this red Zerg?
MVP player.
Find out. Billions of dollars in diamonds are on the line right now.
People didn't know that was part of the Up and Down matches.
Yeah. We waited till now to announce it. Big surprise for everyone. There is our blue Zerg. Member of the team Zenix, he is.
Zenix Kyrix going for an extractor trick to get an extra drone out, whereas Violet has gone for a 10 pool.
Ooh, interesting. And thanks to LG, Intel, and G-Skill for making that 10 pool possible.
Yeah, a little bit of an interesting build, and he's going to squeeze out an extra drone there with the extractor trick as well, getting it pulled out. And it is actually, you know, there's debate as to whether the extractor trick helps out your economy or not, but there's actually larva management to figure out. Sometimes you use the extractor trick so you can get the most out of your larva, because if you're at 3 larva, you don't make any more. So if you can get that extra drone out and then produce that 3rd larva, you actually get an extra larva out of it. Just kind of an interesting little tidbit. And he's actually gone for gas pool up here for Kyrix. So he actually is going to have a later pool, but I think he might be able to hold it off, depending on how aggressive Violet is.
Yeah, it's going to kind of depend. I mean, the spawning pool for Violet is probably going to be up pretty quickly.
Yeah, and the time it takes for those Lings to cross the map.
I think it's going to be up just in time.
Yeah,
and he's going to see the Lings as well.
Exactly.
Yeah. Drone running for its life. And ZVZ, a lot of that early game is Zergling management. I mean, you really need to have good micro in ZVZ.
Yeah. Now, Kirix actually didn't see it quite soon enough, so he didn't save up Larva to get some Zerglings out, so he's going to be a little bit rushed. And that means these six Zerglings, are going to get in there before too many are hatched.
Uh-oh.
And unfortunately, he only has two morphing right now, and he did not go for a spine crawler. He's just going to have to micro his drones against this. That might not be the best way to do it. He's microing his drones pretty well, though.
Oh, trying to get that surround.
Pulling the hurt ones back, and there's some Zerglings popping out. So now if he fights with Zerglings and drones in that choke, he's going to be in good shape.
Uh-oh, this is not the best lineup for Kirix right now, but the queen pops out just in time, protecting your babies.
Nicely done. And
that's right.
Yeah, with some pretty good drone micro, ends up with a decent... He actually has less drones, but he's in a good position, I think.
So I kind of wonder if Violet did that early pool just because he's seen Kirix do those two early pools in his last DBZs, and he wanted to be safe. I kind of wonder if that was the motivation behind that.
Huh.
Either way, he was able to put a little bit of pressure on his opponent. Now,
yeah.
Economy is huge in ZVZ, and right now, Violet is actually one drone ahead, which may not seem like a whole lot, but really in ZVZ, it is a big deal. Every drone counts, Ling counts.
Yeah, that was actually...
I like that.
Yeah, that was actually kind of interesting. He made just those six Zerglings and then droned from there. And I was kind of expecting him to rally more Zerglings, but he didn't. He just went drones from there. And I kind of like that move because if you've ever done a build like that, those last Zerglings come out so late, they don't really show up to the fight in time. So it's actually better to just drone up. And he's got two queens now.
Oh, really fast expansion for Kirix. That can be a little bit risky, but oh no, it's Violet. He lost an Overlord. That is not something you want to do at all at this stage of the game. That's 100 minerals that could be spent on two drones.
Yeah, but here's the thing. Zergling speed is about to finish, and before that Overlord died, before he was supply blocked, he made 14 Zerglings.
Oh,
he's
wow.
Now sending a force of 24 Speedlings out onto the map, and Kirix has an expansion up.
Yep.
No forces to speak of. He's just dropped out some larva, but I don't think it's going to be enough.
And that's the right decision. He needs all the minerals he can get for spine crawlers and Lings. Putting down one right now, but yeah,
they're going to be enough.
Queens don't block the
ramp.
Block the ramp, and the queens are going to go down.
And that's
just bypassing the spine crawler. That is going to be basically it.
That's game there, ladies and gentlemen. That is not what you want to have happen. He's got a roach worn up, but he's going to lose every single drone before the roach is hatched.
Link's coming out, and actually, Kirix may barely hold this. I don't think he's going to be able to, though. Maybe he will.
He actually...
canceling the spine crawler at the very last second.
Yeah, he holds, but it's 21 drones to 8. He literally has triple the economy of Kirix right now, and Kirix is actually producing... he produced a couple more Lings, and now he's trying to drone up again and get another queen, but there's no way he's going to catch up in economy.
Yeah, so that may not seem like it, but that really is the game right there. I mean, it is so, so difficult to come back from a situation where you're that many drones behind in ZVZ. It all comes down to that incomplete wall off. Those queens were not on hold position. The Zerglings were able to just kind of squeeze through, kind of like run under their skirts, so to speak.
Violet is still producing Zerglings. He's getting his Roach Warren. I like the Roach Warren because basically at this point he's got such a better economy. All he has to do is make roaches, and no matter what Kirix makes, the roaches will counter it. There's no way he can make enough of anything to beat mass roaches off this soon-to-be two-base economy. He might just win with these extra Zerglings, though.
Yeah, well, Kirix, he's trying to make some roaches himself, but like you said, it's just not going to be enough. Here come a ton of Zerglings from Violet right now. It may not even matter. The roaches are about to pop. And the Lings get the surround on the queen right now. Roaches do okay against Speedlings. And those Lings, not really doing a whole lot. Getting kind of bunched up there a little bit. He may just decide to pull back. Yep, he is indeed doing that.
Yep, pretty nice defense. If you can get your roaches in a little bit of a wall like he did in the middle of the mineral line, they're actually very good against Speedlings. However, I lost some more drones. Back down to 9 drones. for Keurig, so he can keep those roaches on that ramp and get a few more drones, but it's only a matter of time until Violet produces three or four times the roaches and discharges up there.
Yeah, when you're on two base like this, too, you're kind of on cruise control. You know you can just go speedling roach and win like that. So right now, I'm thinking Keurig may actually try to expand. He is saving up some minerals, but yeah, he just doesn't have the economy. It's going to be tough. It's kind of a slow death.
Well, at this point, Violet only has double the economy instead of triple of Keurig.
That's true.
So he's sort of catching up in a not really catching up sense.
Roach is keeping him safe for the meantime. They are able to block off that ramp. It's going to make it tough for Lynx to run by.
Oh, this is it. 10 roaches are about to hatch. For Violet, he's going to have over a dozen.
Yep.
He's already got a bunch of speedlings on the map. And he's got pretty much more roaches than Keurig has roaches and drones combined.
Yep.
At this point. Actually, not literally. But he's going to charge these roaches up the map, rally speedlings. And by the way, the reason you do that, the reason why you hear people say that is because the speedlings are so fast, they actually catch up to the roach army and are able to engage at the same time since the roaches slowly cross the map. So anyway, it's going to be roaches. About 20 more Lings are going
to
join in, and we're going
to
see a little bit of a slaughter, and Keurig leave the game momentarily, but let's see if he can at least go out with a bang.
Oh yeah, all those Lings combined with the roaches, even despite the concave, there's the GG.
There's the GG.
Violet making a pretty quick game one.
Yep.
Pretty good.
Played it pretty well. Looking got that very early pool, put on the pressure with only 6 Zerglings, did a little damage, droned up. Turtles, got some drones, and then just won the econ game with a mass Zergling attack that Keurig did not expect. He's like, oh, we're going to play macro? You're going to turtle and get 2 queens on your ramp and a spine crawler? Mm-hmm. Well, you're obviously droning up if you're playing so defensively, so I'll get an expansion. And then, whoa, infinity Zerglings.
That's right.
That's what I heard him say that in the booth. I was
like,
what?
All the way from there.
Oh, yeah.
Infinity Zerglings. That's what he said.
So Keurig loses game one, and I'm not terribly surprised. No offense to the guy. He's a great player, but he's not nearly as great as Violet.
Well,
and he hasn't been on his game in the last couple seasons.
Yeah, I think Violet's ZVZ is better than Keurig's ZVZ.
Yeah.
But then again, I mean, it could go anyone's way. I mean,
It's only game one.
Any given Wednesday, right? That's what they say
you know,
about Keurig's, StarCraft.
Keurig could very easily do a cheesy all-in game two and actually win.
Well, I think
I'm sorry. I shouldn't.
So mean.
I'm just so disappointed in the double all-ins from
Moltres mad.
From the series against Lucira. Anyway, we are going to see what happens in game two. It's going to be on Tal'Darim Altar, a very large map.
Yeah.
We'll see how that plays out in this Zerg versus Zerg matchup here at the GSL.
Very soon.